In this video, we're going to take a look at a compound continuous interest problem where we solve for one of the values in the exponent of the formula. Let's get started. The first thing we need is our compound continuous interest formula. A equals P times E, that's the exponential E, raised to the RT power, where A is the final amount at the end of the investment, P is the principal investment, the balance at the beginning, E is the exponential E, R is the rate as a decimal, and T is the number of years that we're going to invest the original balance. So let's read the problem. How long would it take an investment to double if it's put into a savings account that earns 5% interest compounded continuously? Well, the first thing we notice, the only number we're given is 5%. Well, how are we going to find the answer to a problem when all we're given is one of the four pieces? Well, this has a little something to do with the concept of doubling. Okay? If I double, that means that whatever my original balance was, I'm going to double that to find my final balance at the end. Well, the final balance at the end is A. So if I go back to my formula and I replace A with double whatever my original amount is, let's see what happens. 2P is equal to P times E to the, well, we know what the interest is as a decimal, that's 0.05T. Well, when we're looking at this, if we look at our algebra, normally when we're solving for an exponential, we need to get rid of everything that's in front of the exponential first, so that we have the exponential all by itself. Well, normally what we do is we divide both sides by whatever is being multiplied by the exponential. Well, if I divide both sides by this p, we'll see very quickly that it cancels out on both sides. Now, this is a pretty interesting property. That means it doesn't matter how much we invest. If we invest $1 or $1 million, the amount of time it would take to double is the same. So we've got our formula. Let's start simplifying. Let's rewrite this. 2 equals E to the 0.05t. Now that we have the exponential by itself, we're still looking for this t up here that's in this exponent. So in order to get to that, we're going to have to take the logarithm of both sides. Since I've got a base of e, I want to make sure to use the natural logarithm. Okay. Doing so, I'll take the natural log of both sides. I'm going to have the ln of 2 on the left side, and that's going to be equal to the ln of e to the 0.05t. Now, what we have here is some cancellation. If we remember our logarithm rules, it says that whatever the exponent is in a logarithm can be brought down in front as something multiplied by the logarithm. And then what's left is this ln of e, and this is a very special property. The reason why we use natural logarithm to begin with is that the ln of e is just 1, they kind of cancel each other out. So we have the ln of 2 is equal to, after that ln of e cancels out and that 0.05t is brought down, that's all that's left over here. Now if I want to know what t is, all I have to do is divide both sides by this 0.05. And we get some answer. Now generally we want to know what the actual decimal value of this is, so let's go to our calculator. First thing we need to do is put in the ln of 2 divided by 0.05, and that is a t value where t is equal to 13.5 1.86 years. Now, we'll have to be careful as to what the problem asks as far as rounding is concerned. It may ask to round to the nearest year, in which case the answer would be 14, or maybe it's two decimal places, just like this answer provided.